In this Skin workshop, we are going to create a magical fantasy image. If you want to follow along, you can find the download link for the images in the video description. When we first open GIMP and then our image folder, we can select all four images and bring them into GIMP by drag and drop. In this way, they will open as separate images. Make sure that the foreground image is visible. Click on the zoom icon in the top right of the window to maximize the image in the window. Click and drag the thumbnail of the background image via the thumbnail of the foreground image into the foreground image. Double-click on the name and rename it background. Hit enter. Right-click on the layer and click add layer mask. Leave the layer mask on white full opacity and just click add. Activate the blend tool and drag a line upwards to blend the foreground and the background image together. We can do this again and again until we are satisfied. Now select the foreground layer. Click on colors in the menu bar and then on use saturation. Here we make the hue -170 and the saturation -70. Click OK. Select the background layer and make sure to select the image and not the layer mask. A white border indicates that the image is selected. Go to colors and to curves. Make the background lighter and reduce the contrast by moving the diagonal line in the dialog box. Click OK. Click on the new layer button, rename it fog, leave the layer fill type on transparency and click OK. Now we activate the paintbrush in the toolbox. Swap the foreground background colors, so white is our foreground color. Make the opacity about 30. Choose brush hardness 0.25. And make it size somewhere around 400. Now we can paint the fog where the foreground touches the background. When this is to our liking, we click on the thumbnail of the wolf image. Right-click on the layer and hit Add Alpha Channel. We make a duplicate of this layer by clicking on the duplicate button at the bottom of the layers panel. Make the bottom layer invisible by clicking the eye. Now click the free select tool active. Zoom in by holding the control key down and then rolling the mouse wheel away from you. We will start with the front leg. Click points along the edge of the leg. Try to stay just a little bit within the boundaries of the subject. By holding the left mouse button down, we can draw a selection line. When we press and hold the spacebar, we can move the image by moving the mouse without clicking. Letting go of the mouse gives us the free select tool again. Click some more points. With the backspace key, we can undo one or more previous made points. Where the fur of the wolf gets a bit rougher, we select a bit further inside the boundary of our subject. In this way, we select the whole wolf. For the sake of the tutorial, we will go fast forward now. When we are back at the first point, we place the last point over the first point, and when this colors yellow, we can click to close the selection. Now go to View, Zoom, and click Fit Image in Window. Now we go to Select, click Feather, and here we just click OK to feather the selection with 5 pixels. Back to Select and hit Invert. Now to edit, and here we hit clear. Back to select again, and hit none. Go to the toolbox, and here we make the smudge tool active. Choose brush bristles 02, and make the size around 25. Zoom in to the front leg of the wolf again, and start clicking and jittering along the boundary to make a furry edge. We can make the rate higher to create longer hairs. Make sure to follow the flow of the hair. We can toggle the bottom layer on and off as a reference to see if we're still on the right track. Again, we will go fast forward. When you think it's okay, we go to View, Zoom, and Fit Image in Window. Go to Edit, and click Copy. Click on the thumbnail of our background foreground image, and then we go back to Edit, and we click Paste. We now have a floating layer. Hit the New Layer button at the bottom of the Layers panel to change it into an actual layer. Double click on the name, and change it to Wolf. Hit Enter. Now we activate the Scale tool. At Guides we select Center Lines, so we do not have so much lines in our image. Click in the image, and lock the chain in the dialog box to lock the aspect ratio when we scale the image. Make the wolf layer temporarily invisible by clicking the eye, then scale the image. By click and drag in the center circle, we can move the whole image. When it looks okay, we click Scale. Go ahead and make the wolf layer visible again. Go to Colors, Curves, and make the contrast a bit higher, like shown in the video. Click OK. Go to Filters, Light and Shadow, and click on Drop Shadow. Reduce the opacity to 50, and click OK. Then we activate the Drop Shadow layer. Now we go to the menu bar and click on Layer, Transform, and here we click Flip Vertically. Now click on the Perspective tool, and change the perspective in a way that makes a natural looking shadow. When this is to our liking, we click Transform. Make the Eraser tool active. Choose Brush Hardness 0.75, and make the size around 100. Then erase the part of the shadow that doesn't belong there. In the next step, we are going to make another new layer by clicking on the New Layer button. Name this layer Shadow 2 and click OK. Move it by click and drag to the top of the layer stack. Select the paintbrush. Toggle the foreground background colors back, so black is our foreground color. Reduce the opacity to 20. Choose brush hardness 0.25. And make the size around 150. Use the control key and the mouse wheel again to zoom in or out, and the space bar to move the image. Zoom in and make the shadow a bit darker where the wolf touches the ground. Then we reduce the size to around 50. And again, we add some more shadow. looks okay, we go to View, to Zoom, and then Fit Image in Window. In the next step, we will bring the girl image into our project. Click and drag the thumbnail of the image with the girl via the thumbnail of our project into our project. Double-click on the name and change it to Girl. Hit Enter. Click the Scale tool active and click in the image. Make the girl layer invisible. We can now scale the image and move it to its proper position. When we think it's okay, we click Scale. Make the layer visible again. Activate the Dodge Burn tool. Leave it at brush 025. Choose the option Burn, which makes everything a bit darker. And again, zoom with the Control key and the mouse wheel and use the spacebar to move the image. Now we can make the side of the girl a bit darker by making several long strokes. Click Colors, use Saturation, and make the saturation minus 20 by clicking 2 times on the slider line. Then hit OK. When we are sure that the girl is edited to our liking, we place it by click and drag above the wolf layer. Then we right-click on the girl layer and hit Merge Down. Activate the Smudge tool. Choose Brush Bristles 02. Zoom in and smudge the hair of the wolf like shown in the video. When this looks good, we click on the image of the background layer. Make sure that there is a white border around the image to indicate that the image and not the layer mask is selected. Go to View, Zoom, and Fit Image in Window. Then we go to Filters, Light and Shadow, and click on Lightning Effect. Click one time on the slider line to change the distance to 300. Go ahead and click on the Light tab and change the X position to 1,30. Hit Enter. Now we can click OK. Back to Filters, Light and Shadow, and now we go to Supernova. Click in the center of the sunlight in the preview pane. Then we click on Color. At the HTML notation we fill in E, F, D, 7, 9, 5. Hit Enter on your keyboard to see the color in the current old section. Then click OK. Now make the radius 40, and again click OK. Click in the toolbox on the Dodge Burn tool. Choose Brush Hardness 0.75 and make the size 30. Check the option Dodge. Now select the wolf layer and zoom into the eye of the wolf. Click a few times in the eye so this lights up a little. Go to View, Zoom, and Fit Image in Window. Click on the New Layer button. Name it Vignette, and make sure that the layer fill type is Transparency. Then click OK. Activate the paintbrush. Select Brush Hardness 0.25 and make the size about 500. Make the left top corner and the right bottom corner a bit darker. And there we have it, a magical fantasy image. I hope you have enjoyed this video, and if that's the case, please do not forget to like it, maybe leave a nice comment to support my channel, and subscribe if you haven't done already. Thank you very much for watching.